In this video, I will provide a brief introduction of RStudio. Let's start with the layout. As you can see, RStudio is divided into four panels, and you can adjust the size of them by dragging these dividers. You can also minimize a section by pressing this icon. The top left quadrant we can think of as a notepad, where you can type and save notes and scripts. If you don't see this section, you can create one by pressing this icon and then selecting RScript. This bottom left section is called the console, which is where you can directly enter and execute lines of code. The top right section is where we can store groups of data. And this bottom right section has a few interesting features, such as you can ask for help. Now that we have a slightly better idea of what we are looking at, I can show you some simple codes to help you get a feel of RStudio. So it's easy to see in this video, I will start by pressing the command button and the plus button to zoom in slightly. I'm on a Mac, so if you're on a PC or Linux system, it would be the control button and the plus symbol. To learn the core principles in a simple manner, I like to start with some easy arithmetic. For example, suppose I wanted to calculate 1 plus 1. In a calculator, I would type 1 plus 1 equals. However, in RStudio, we don't need to put an equals sign. In fact, it wouldn't work if we did. Instead, all we need to enter in the console is 1 plus 1, and then we need to execute that command, and it will return back to us the result. So I enter 1 plus 1, and then I press Enter on my keyboard, and it returns back the result. Similarly, to subtract, we enter 1 minus 1, we press Enter, and it returns back the result. If we wanted to multiply numbers, we can use the asterisk symbol. So 2 asterisk 2, and then Enter, will give us 4. And finally, division. To divide numbers, you can use the forward slash button. So 4 forward slash 2 would mean 4 divided by 2. Therefore, if we press Enter, we get 2. Naturally, in RStudio, we can work with large groups of numbers and sets of data. And so, rather than looking at individual numbers, let's look at some simple commands for groups of numbers. And rather than importing data, which I will cover in a later lesson, we can create some test data directly within RStudio from the console. Let's suppose our test data was a simple group of four numbers, 2, 4, 6, and 8. We could name this group to make it easier to work with. And to do that, you can place parentheses or brackets around the group of numbers, like so. Then we need to decide what we will call this group of numbers. Let's just call them X. So we put the letter X in front of the numbers. Then we need to tell RStudio that we want to assign X to the group of numbers, and we do that with the equals sign, X equals 2468. And finally, we need to tell RStudio that these numbers are a group, and to do that we use the letter C. When teaching this to people, to help them remember, I often say to think of a word beginning with C that represents a group. That could be a club, committee, conference, council, etc. Or you could think of it as combining numbers, concatenating them, consolidating them, and so on. Whatever works for you. For now, we can call it a collection of numbers. So once we execute this line of code, we will be telling RStudio that from now on, X is no longer just a random letter. It is a name of a collection of numbers, and those numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8. I will now press Enter to execute the code, and we can see that it has been stored in the top right panel. Remember that it is here where we can see what sets of data and values have been created or loaded in RStudio. If we wanted to remove X, you could type RM, which stands for remove, and then tell RStudio what you want to remove, which in this case is X. And as you can see, it is now no longer in the top right panel. If you wanted to add it back, rather than typing it out again, you can press the up arrow on your keyboard, as this will cycle through your previous commands. So if I press the up arrow now, I can see the remove command that I just executed. And if I press the up arrow again, I can see where X was created. And then if I press Enter, it will execute that command again. And we can see that X has now reappeared in the top right panel. So now we have our collection of numbers back we can study it. For instance, we might want to know what the total is if we added all four numbers together. To do that, we could ask RStudio, what is the sum of x? When I press enter, it will add up the numbers in our collection together and return the result. And there we can see that it has worked. There are many things we might want to know, but to give a couple more simple examples, we could ask, what is the highest number in our collection? To do that, we say, what is the max value in our collection? And similarly, if we wanted to find the lowest number, we could ask, what is the minimum value? Now, let's suppose you wanted to do all of this in one go. You wanted to create the collection and find out the total, the max value, and the minimum value in one click. Let's start by removing x, and let's create a little script using our notepad in the top left. Here I can type each line. So I want our collection of numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, to be known as x, and I want to find out the sum of x, the max value, and the min value. If I wanted to add notes for future reference, and I didn't want it to interfere with the script, I can write the note and then put a hashtag in front of it. This way RStudio won't get confused. So with that done, I can highlight all, then press run, and it will run the script. Now, let's suppose we did that, and we had a couple of error messages. Let's take a quick look at how we might fix them. To break the script, I will remove the hashtag and remove this bracket here. Now, when I run the script, it will provide us with some useful error messages. These are helpful as they will tell us where the problems are in our script and what functions in particular were the issue. So first, we can see that it has gotten confused with this is. However, we know that that was just a note, and therefore we just need to add the hashtag in front of it. Second, it's telling us that there is a problem with the max function. Now, supposing we didn't know it needed a closing bracket, and so we needed to learn a little bit more about the max function, we can ask RStudio by putting a question mark in front of max and hitting enter in the console. This will provide additional information and provide examples in the bottom right panel of RStudio. And usually, I find you can find out what you may have done wrong pretty quickly without having to leave RStudio. So let's make our fixes, a hashtag here, and a closing bracket here, and then we can run the script again. And now there are no error messages. That's all for this brief introduction. I hope it's been helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.